Hello everybody and welcome to Autobox Plays Fire Emblem. Let's see, oh yeah, we just got done with chapter 7, now it's time to begin chapter 18, no, chapter 17. Elwood arrives on the shores of Valor with a new companion in his numbers, an enigmatic young girl named Ninian. The majority of the island is covered in a dense forest. Legend has it that no one has ever returned from these dark woods. A dense fog crawls over the party, engulfing them one by one. Cautiously, they move deeper into the trees. Oh, sorry about the mouse pointer. Chapter 18, The Dread Isle. The Dragon's Gate.
Shame on you, Marcus Ferret. You freed the boy and the girl.
I will not let you move unopposed.
What? What shall we do, Lord Nurgle? With both siblings gone, we can no longer hold the ceremony.
How many times must I tell you, Lord Darren? You are being used by this man. By helping him bring dragons back into this world, you are helping him destroy mankind. Do you not understand?
Destroy humanity? Dragons may have been a threat to mankind in ages past, but though with Lord Nurgle's power, we have nothing to fear. Lord Nurgle can control dragons. Ha ha ha.
Lord Darren, you're already lost.
I'd planned to start a war in Lycia. The war I was plotting in Lycia would have generated a glorious amount of force in one blow. You were not equal to the task, it seems. Not to worry, I have other means at hand.
Black-hearted fiend.
Blech. Hold your tongue. There is still a task you must perform for me. Ephidel! Limstella! My beloved morphs, my beauteous works of art. I have new jobs for you, my pets. First, Limstella, you will go to Briran and contact Sonia. I want you to arrange a meeting with the king.
Understood.
Ephidel, take this man, Marcus Laus, and go. I want you to exterminate the mice who landed on this island.
Yes, master.
That leaves you, Marcus Ferret. It seems your legacy is one of endurance. The mouse who interfered with my conquest of Lycia is named Elwood. Should he be congratulated on making it this far?
Lord Elwood? My son is here? Stop. Do with what you will with me, but let my son be.
Remember the siblings you freed? The girl's here too. As a matter of fact, she's with your son, Elwood. Quite a delicious twist of fate, wouldn't you say?
This can't be.
Elwood will die in these woods. The girl will be returned to me, and the ceremony will take place. Despite those long hours of torture, you remain undaunted. Such courage will make you the perfect sacrifice, Marcus Ferret.
Elwood, turn back. Take the girl and flee, please. I can't believe it's come to this. I must inform Lord Hector of these events. If I hurry, I may be in time. What?
Layla, where are you going?
Lord Ephidel, the sentries. I'm going to check on.
You overheard, didn't you not? And I had such hopes for you.
Jafar.
Ah!
The punishment for traitors is death.
Ah! Matthew. Impressive, Jafar. Your power is beyond compare. Take this woman's corpse and leave it in the forest. Let it serve as a warning to those fools.
Valor Isle. Let's get through these woods. It's starting to get foggy, trying to get separated. Enter and be lost. It feels like we're not coming back.
Hector, are you trying to curse us?
Are you well, Ninian?
Yes,
I'll be fine. Someone's there. Who? A sentry? Layla, is that you? Impressive work finding your way here. Something's wrong. Layla? She's dead. No! This can't be. She was one of our best spies, Layla. I'm sorry, Matthew. Why do you apologize, my lord? Layla blundered, that's all. Matthew, Layla was... she was... After this mission, I was going to ask her to put this life behind her. Waited too long, didn't I? My lord, might I rejoin you later? She has to be buried. Of course. I'll go with you. Let them be alone. There's nothing else we can do. Blast! They put her out here for us to find like this? Unforgivable. This is a foul deed, beyond foul. Let's go. The foe is somewhere in this forest. We must stop this before any more die. Ah! Beware, something comes! What? Yeah! Lindis!
If you value her life, send the girl to me.
Ah! You're Sakaian!
That's correct. I'm Uhai of the Black Fang. I've been sent to capture the girl, and to kill a lot of you. If, however, you hand over the girl and depart the island at once, I'll grant you your lives. And if we refuse? You know nothing, little lord. Nothing of Nurgle's might, nothing of his terrible power. You're ignorant, and so you hope to oppose him. You are insects railing against the heavens. Your actions will change nothing. Speak no more foolishness and be gone!
Maybe we don't know what it is we're fighting, but if we flee, our loss is assured. We will continue to struggle, and we may yet prevail.
Folly.
What? Why are you letting me go?
Holding a woman hostage during battles is shameful. You too are of Sakai, and I have a mind to show you mercy. I will let you die with a sword in your hand, but rest assured, I will kill you all here. But be of good cheer. In dying, you shall be spared the calamity that is to come.
Ninian, you must hide. We will meet the enemy. Okay. So, let's actually take a quick peek of the map. So, as you can see, it's very, very foggy. The boss is down here, from what I remember. Let's see. There doesn't seem to be any other nonsense going on over here, so let's take a look. He actually has a torch staff. That's interesting, actually. I think it would be in my best interest, actually, to make it so that I can get that torch staff for Priscilla. So that way she can just straight up, like, start using that staff. But anyway, so that's basically what's going on here. And there is a guidance chapter after this, so that's something I definitely do want to get. The only way that you can get that is by beating the boss within 15 turns or less, so if we can get it under sub 15, that would be ideal. Okay, so considering that, let us actually... let's see. Yeah, let's actually, make it so the way we can do that. That shouldn't be straight up a problem. So anyway, I want to make it so that I can pick my units. Okay, so there are a couple things that I want to make it clear. We do actually get a new unit on this map, which is actually pretty freaking sweet. I think he might be on the map already. But anyway, it's Dart. Dart is a pirate, and he is probably the best axe wielder in the game. Because a pirate, which you can use an ocean seal on, He can turn it into a berserker, and berserkers are freaking crazy. They're like the axe-wielding sword masters, but they have a really high health pool. They only use axes, they can walk on water, high health pool, they hit super hard, and they have like pretty damn good crit chance. So that's obviously something we want, so let us actually try to get that. There's also another unit that actually spawns in this area. It's Fiora, I believe. It's the eldest of the three Pegasus sisters. So there is Florina, Farina, and Fiora, if I believe. Fiora should be coming into this chapter sometime soon. So we will definitely want that. So here's the thing. We're gonna make it so that we can get all the units that we want in here. So we know that we definitely want Priscilla, because she's our dedicated healer. Matthew is nice to have, if only for the fact that he allows us to see more, right? And having more vision through the fog is always good. Oswin isn't necessarily going to be super, super important for this particular map, mostly because we're probably going to be going against a lot of pirates. Considering that, let's actually take a look at our augury. Yes, oh wait, you're taking Olmo to the Dread Isle? Oh, terrible wish, no. Yes, the augury. Okay, we pay 80 gold. It'll take a little more gold if you're asking for choosing. Ask in when you have enough money. Oh, Alamat, we don't actually have any money. Oh, that's too funny. Okay, I think we spent all of it. Considering that, let's transfer all the stuff that we don't necessarily need. So, we don't need the flux on Priscilla. Although it would be awesome to get a promoted unit right now, it's not the ideal time. Matthew, you will be giving your speed wings back. Well, if anything, we can definitely sell this, and this should be able to get us the augury. So let's go ahead and do that. Augury. Yes, yes, yes. Alright, let's see. Fog. You should take a thief with you, and torches will make things easier too. I sense the foe has a strange item. Watch your possessions closely. Take the orchard-haired Skyrider. There is someone who she should meet. Alright, fair enough. So basically she's saying, bring Fiora, bring something with torches, and be careful of your items, I suppose. I'm not sure about that particular part, but anyway, that's something that we should keep in mind. I really want to bring Hector, but Raven also needs some. Most of these people straight up needs some XP. Okay, so here's the thing. I am not going to take Lynn, nor am I going to take Oswin. I'm going to take Hector, and I'm going to take Bart. They're axe wielders, they need some levels, and they should be totally fine to kick some ass. Now, okay, we will give you an extra tome. You are Elowitz fine. You are totally fine. Yeah, she's fine. That's good. Matthew is good. If anything, we might be able to give him a torch. So, is there a torch in here? Hey, there is. Woo! All right. So he has the torch. So that should increase his vision like a freaking ton. So that's awesome. So, does he necessarily need that Lance Reaver? Not really. If anything, let's give him a steel axe. I know we have one. Wait, what the fuck? Where's our steel axe? I thought we bought steel axes. Am I crazy? I guess I'm crazy, because I thought we totally bought steel axes. Never mind. Might have been in our other parts, but whatever. Okay, fine, fine, fine. That's okay. That is totally okay. Yeah, this is okay. This is alright. Yeah, this is good. Wait, let's see. Let's take a look at Hector's stats. He has 13 strength and 12 skill. Holy fuck, he's actually fucking awesome. You know what? You're good. You are totally good. You have more strength than Hector, even though you can't hit as accurately as he can. It should still totally be fine. Okay, considering that, We have a decent balance. We have lots of magic users and a lot of sword users. Sword user being Elwood, Matthew, Raven, Guy, and that's it. We have a good amount of ranged options. We have a good amount of mobility. We have some vision, and everyone seems to be more or less decked out. Let's actually take a look at the formation now and figure it out from here. So, first things first. I think it's in our best interest to actually make it so that we can kill this thief. Killing this thief will allow Florina to actually get this particular staff, which would allow Priscilla to just straight up get more levels, so that's always good. Bart, you will go down here, and who can honestly use some more levels? Guy, you're 13 already. Alright, so here's the thing. I am actually going to be placing Raven and Bart down this area, and then I'm also going to be placing Lucius. Placing Lucius Canis back there. You are going to be placed back here, and you know what, if anything, I think this is totally okay. It gives the option of actually having Matthew being up here to reach here, killing this guy. He should be able to totally kill this guy, or at least dodge him. Yeah, that should be good. If anything, let's save and then let's begin. We've spent enough time setting up. All right, let's do it. Melanus became level 10. Yes, we will deploy him. You're Autobox, right? I'm Dart, leader of Fargus' Suicide Squad. The captain's ordered me to follow your orders, so what do you want me to take care of? I'm back, my lord. Matthew, are you sure you don't have to? What are you talking about? Look at this eerie place, this thick fog. This is exactly why you brought me with you. Yet, if Layla knew I was shirking my duties, she would never have forgiven me. I'm fine. I will work twice as hard for Ocidia in her honor. I understand. I'm counting on you. As well you should, my lord. Tell me, Layla. This is what you wanted, right? You wouldn't want me to give up. I'll mourn for you when our battle is won. I must fulfill my duty. So rest. I promise I will take care of everything. Well, shit, that's sad. Alright, so let's take a look over here and see if we can take out this guy. Unfortunately, we're a little short. So considering that, he can actually attack from a distance, and you know what? It might not necessarily be the worst idea. So here's the thing. I'm gonna actually go here and have Matthew attack. He shouldn't be taking any damage, and it'll make it so that Dart can actually go ahead and pick up the kill. Great, good dodge, exactly what I wanted. Alright, cool. So you are going to go here. There doesn't seem to be anyone coming up from here, at least we can't see anything. We only got the edge of this particular spot. So considering that, we're gonna go place Dart here, and he's gonna use his hand axe. Surprisingly, he's actually able to hit, because if we take a look at his stats after he's done with this battle, you're gonna see that they're not particularly amazing. Granted, he's start at level 8, and he's very similar to how Bart is. So, like, take that into consideration in terms of his growth. Alright, so we're gonna place you here and see how you're gonna do. Unfortunately, it doesn't actually seem we're gonna get the kill on you. Just because your speed is not necessarily fast enough to actually get that double hit off. Alright, fair enough then. Okay, we're gonna give you the Slim Lance and hope that you are actually able to hit. I mean, not like, to get a crit. If not, not the end of the world, but it's not necessarily too ideal. If anything, that one hit is totally fine. At least he wasn't able to get the second hit off. Not that one extra point of damage would have mattered too much, but, you know, whatever. Alrighty, so his only options are to actually go back into this area. If anything, it'll be luring our available units down here to chase him, but I do still think that's actually in our best interest. If Florina ends up killing the thief, then she would be able to pick up that green torch staff that he's holding, and we can just fly it over to Priscilla. So that should be totally fine. We can set up our units over here now. So that's something we will definitely be doing. So we're gonna place him down here. And he's actually gonna reveal somebody. Okay. Unfortunately, we're not gonna be able to place another unit beside him just because of the fact that the fort takes two movements to go through, I assume. So we're just gonna move as many of our units down here as possible. At least through this choke. But it should be totally fine. We are gonna leave a unit behind. I'm not necessarily sure who though exactly. So we're just gonna place you guys here. Lucius, you're gonna go here, because you are more accurate than Canis and Urk. So if anyone actually attacks you from that fort, you will be able to kill them pretty damn easily. So that's pretty sweet. We're gonna place you here and equip you with your fire. And then Rebecca, you're gonna go down here next to everyone, and yeah, this is good. And then we will end our turn after Priscilla goes down here. Anything? We'll just wait. Alright, let's see how this goes. Okay, so we already got a first attack. He dodged like a fucking champ. Oh, baby. Alright, good job, Raven. Good job. Alright, just as I expected. Alright, that little extra bit of damage, not too bad, because it can definitely... Whoa, what the fuck? You missed. Dog, I was busy talking so much good shit about you, saying that, oh, you're more accurate than you will. You should totally be able to hit. You let me down, Lucius. You let me down. Alright. Asshole. Alright, well, we're gonna place Matthew down here, and then we're gonna have him use a torch. This will increase his vision by a lot, so it should open up probably this entire half of this map. So, yeah, we can see a lot. Considering that, we're gonna place you here, and you are going to equip your steel axe. Yeah, and then you are gonna go here, and then you are just gonna kill this guy. I do still, even though it actually puts you out from the rest of the party, it's still probably better that you actually get that torch staff, just because of the fact that thieves are notorious for actually leaving the level, preemptively, so this is totally fine. These units should only be able to attack fight Florina, and yeah, they'll be totally fine. If anything, the shaman user isn't... The only scary person is the shaman user, because these pirates aren't going to be able to like actually get close to her. And if anything, she should be able to do a little bit of damage, making it so that Dart or Matthew can be able to get the kill. And granted, if she actually gets some, that's not too bad. Alright, let's take a look over onto the left side of the map and take stock of what's going on. So if anything, we can actually have Canis pick up a kill, and I think that's okay. So Canis, see if you can take this guy out, and I hope you actually do. Alright, good, thank you. Thank you. Alright, now with that unit out of the way, we will be able to attack the Nomad, and let's see, who do we necessarily want to attack the Nomad with? Alright, let's... Okay, we're gonna switch location like this. So we're gonna have Raven attack this Nomad, and then we're gonna have Bart attack the other unit that Raven just attacked last turn. This will allow Bart to get some XP and also make it so that's... Yeah, he's not gonna get completely fucked. If anything, we don't necessarily need to have the longsword, nor do we necessarily... We don't send me a torch, just put that back. Alright, Bart, get in there. Alright, good. Good, good, good. So now, we will definitely be able to heal Lucius, and we're just gonna use the Mend Staff. We're gonna use the Mend Staff all the way until it's broken, just so that we can actually not to worry too much about all this extra stuff. So from here, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna... I guess it's okay for us to just keep moving our units forward, because we do technically have a time limit as to how long we can actually like spend dealing with these things. from what I remember in previous playthroughs, there are people who actually spawn up here, such as like Pegasus Knights, maybe pirates or something. So I don't feel too bad about actually leaving some of our units behind. It just depends on who I actually want to leave behind. So I'm going to leave Guy, Rebecca, and Ellawood behind here. So if anything, I can actually place Raven maybe over here, depending. Hey, it's a light ruin. Device that blocks units from entering a space. Oh, it's okay. So let's say we were to break one of these down and we put a light one right here. That means no one can actually pass through that. We have to go around. It's like putting a column or like an impassable wall. So we're gonna actually place our units here, but we're not going to attack this. We're gonna make it so that if they do end up attacking those trees, then we could be able to deal with them as they come. All right, so Florina's getting attacked, and she should be totally fine. It's unfortunate she took the hit, but not too bad. This is still fine. All right, the Nosferatu guy is going to attack. It really doesn't make sense that he should hit, but it's not outside of the realm of possibility. Exactly, like, what the fuck? Like, why? Why are you getting hit? Why are you choosing to live this life, Florina? We were better than this. Hey, it's a longbow. Okay. Whoa, I actually got hit. Well, that's surprising. So a longbow is, it increases the range of how far you can attack somebody by like two. And there it is, I found them. These men are Black Fang. Look everyone, your sacrifices were not in vain. I'll fulfill my duty even if I must do it myself. I'm a true Knight of Ilia. No, you bitch. Fuck. Alright, shit. I didn't actually think she would spawn that close. And that's actually pretty bad for me. Because it's gonna take probably a couple turns for Florina to actually make it all the way back here. Because we don't have Nils or anyone like that, so I'm gonna place you back here. It's poor planning on my part. I should have actually anticipated her to actually spawn in that location, but whatever. I was hoping that she would actually kill that torch guy earlier, so it's my fault for having that happen. Alright, if anything, we definitely need to start moving our units around. So I'm actually going to be placing Ellawood, you're going to go here. I don't necessarily know what's going on that part. Guy, you're going to move down here, and we're going to have everyone, have our units retreat back into this location. One, because I don't necessarily want them to die, and two, actually, yeah, we'll use this vulnerary, because that was actually kind of a big hit. Okay, we're going to place you here, and we're going to place Dart here. Should stop anyone from actually attacking him, and we'll keep his hand axe equipped. Okay. So this is Fiora, and I was right, actually. Commander of the 5th Wing of the Ilias Pegasus Knights. Alright, see, she doesn't have as much speed as Florina, but she, from what I remember, she's actually a little tankier, so if we're actually compared Florina to her, in terms of just raw stats, yeah, anyway. Okay, so I want to make it so that we can off these units pretty damn quickly, so is this possible? This is totally possible. You have a lance, okay? You should be able to kill this guy. You should be able to. Yep, you are. Alright, we're gonna have Raven kill this nomad, and then after that we should definitely have Bart go ahead and get the kill on the other unit. Raven, you're almost level 10. This is quite exciting. Alright, get the kill, son. Thank you. Hey, you got a level. Alright, you know what? That's actually totally fine. any sort of strength you can get, not strength, skill you can get is always fucking awesome. So we're gonna place you here, and how will you do against this guy? If anything, you know, this is good. This is totally okay. He can't reach. So, let's see. Elwood's there. We're gonna place Rebecca down here. And then we're also gonna have... If we wanted to, we can have Canis go ahead, or somebody break open this snag. It only has like 2 HP. A couple HP, but the thing is that if we don't end up killing these two, we have this unit to deal with, and we also have this unit to deal with. So it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I actually might be able to take this dude out. So if I really needed to, if I'm gonna complete this level within the set amount of time, I think I need to be more proactive, well, more aggressive with the options that I'm going to be taking. So, breaking down this one little part should allow either Lucius or Irk to go ahead and take on these guys. Alright, who has better skill? If anything, it has to be Irk, who has to hit both shots on this. If not, then someone's going to be in for a world of hurt, that's for sure. And his chances of actually hitting aren't necessarily too much better anyway. Okay, so I think this is fine. I'm gonna take the risk on this. You are gonna hit this guy. You're gonna hit him twice. Oh, the crit, thank you. Crits never miss, so that's actually pretty amazing that you got it. Especially with a 4% chance. Okay, so we're gonna place you here. And you are going to crit him as well, right? And you're gonna get both hits. You're gonna get the second hit, right? Ah, thank you, good job. 10 out of 10. And yeah, you got a level. Alright. So... that's okay, that is okay. An extra bit of skill never hurt anybody. So we're gonna place Hector down here, and we're gonna have him attack with his Iron Axe. Should allow him to get the kill on this Cavalier. Alright, hopefully things turn out not so fucky next turn. Hey, he should be able to wield A-level axes? Okay, Elwood's getting attacked, that's to be anticipated. Hey. Maybe it wouldn't have been a terrible idea to actually have Rebecca go back up Elwood. If only for the fact that she could have gotten extra XP, but nah, whatever. And Raven's level 10, woo! Alright, Raven. Bust, you're breaking my balls. Breaking my balls, Raven. Alright, if you can hit him. It would have been awesome. Hey! Dodge. Ah, you bitch. That was Raven's XP. Oh, hey, we could rescue. Okay, so that's what we're gonna do. Hector, you don't need any extra XP. We're gonna rescue you. And then we're gonna have Florina. Yeah, we're gonna have Florina go over here. And then we're gonna wait. Should have done that in the first place, but whatever. Live and learn, I suppose. Live and learn. Alright. So unfortunately, Dart isn't gonna get too much XP off attacking these dudes. There's not necessarily any better time for him to go attack these homies, though. His accuracy is so shitty that it gets really hard for him to take on these guys. So we are going to place you here, and then we're going to place Dart behind you as sort of backup. And we'll place him with his hand axe. So we'll wait here. Matthew, you have more or less done your job. You can wait over here. Alright, considering that, we want Lucius to back off. Lucius, back off. And then we are gonna place... Who can use the XP? Probably Canis. Alright, so we're gonna place Urk right here. But we're also gonna be placing you here. Fuck! I was hoping that he would have actually gotten that extra attack off. This is rather unfortunate because it makes it so that Priscilla is open to attack. And the longbow makes it so that it's very hard for us to retaliate on our turn, at least, because we don't have anything that's in range. The best we can do is just block him off and then hope we actually take him out. So we're gonna place Bart down here, see what we got going on. Nothing yet. And we're gonna place Raven. We're gonna place Raven here. Okay. So Elwood's the last one left, and unfortunately Rebecca's not gonna be able to get the kill. If anything, he'll be able to weaken the next person who comes his way, and Rebecca should be able to get some XP out of this. You're so average. Your stats are so shitty, dog. Hey. Okay. Alright, let's see how this plays out. Alright. Huh, surprisingly, he got hit. And you got a crit. Alright. Hey, nice dodge. Nice dodge. And as anticipated, this fucking longbow user is being an asshole. Okay. Rebecca, go in here, kill this guy. Kill him, meow. Alright, good. Now... It would be awesome if you got this kill. Ah, fuck. Alright, guy. Kill him. That's the thing about leveling up characters, especially late in the game. Like, you have to feed them all the XP, and it's kind of a pain in the ass sometimes. Alrighty, so... Canis, you need to get the kill. So, how are we gonna do this? If anything, you can get XP, because I can't honestly give you the kill reliably. So, do as much damage as you can, and then from there, we're gonna have... Lucius, if he can reach. Yeah, he should be able to reach, and Lucius, clean him up. Okay, coolio. And we got a longbow. Alright. So we're gonna place Urk down here, see what we got going on, if we can see anything. Not really. So you're gonna go here, and you're gonna heal. Heal Canis. Alright, cool. She should be a level 11. Your stats are like Elwood's. Anyway, so we're gonna drop you here, and then we are going to have your sister talk to you. Sister? Fiora! Florina, why are you here? I'm with Lady Lindis. What are you doing here? I was investigating the Dread Isle for someone. By yourself? No. There were others, a full unit of Pegasus Knights. We were attacked. You can't mean... I misjudged our situation. All of my knights are dead because of me. I am a failure. That's not true. You're a splendid Pegasus Knight. I chose this path because I admired you so. Please, don't do this to yourself.
Florina, please don't cry. I'm sorry. No, it's my fault. The pain of being the sole survivor, it had me trapped. Thank you, Florina. I can see clearly now. Fiora, come and travel with us. It's better to travel with friends than to struggle alone. You're right. I hate to admit it, but I can't do everything alone. Nor can I render my companion's sacrifices moot by going home. Florina, please introduce me to your commander. I'll see if I can offer my services for a short while. She's actually with us for the entire game.
Alright, sweet. So we have Fiora, woo!
Now, if anything, it's a matter of waiting right now, actually. Yeah, go kill him. Kill him. Kill him, meow.
Bam.
I'm assuming B-level swords?
Yeah, B-level swords. Speaking of which, Hector... Yeah, you can use A-axes. A-level axes. I'm gonna place you here. And I'm gonna throw Matthew down here, but I'm also gonna have him use a torch. I really just want to make sure that I'm seeing everything possible on the map. Alright, so there's this guy who should be able to attack us, and there's actually this Nosferatu homie. Luckily, he can't actually reach Priscilla, so that's good. That's very good. This guy will definitely attack Raven, so that's not going to be too much of an issue. But we do want to make it so that we can move our units down here slowly. And speaking of which, let's take the status. We are in turn 5, so this is totally... We should totally be able to complete this in less than 15 turns. Alright, so Elwood's going to wait here, and then everything else should be more or less fine. So let's have this turn play out. They are going ham after darts! If anything, it's good that he actually got a hit off, but... Geez, they're going after him pretty hard. Whoa! Oh, dog, what the fuck?
Nuh-uh, you don't go after Rebecca.
Alright, kill him. Oh, the crit!
Wham!
Okay, well... This is pretty damn surprising. So we're gonna place him here. Hopefully he will get the hit. Yay, he got the hit. Woo, miracles can happen. Damn, that's a lot of XP. Those gains. Alright, so Canis, go here. You are gonna fight your brethren. You're gonna fight the anima dude. Not anima dude. The dark magic guy. You, go here. Break this down. Matthew, break this. I mean, Matthew. Irk, break this down. So from here, you're gonna go down here and give us as much vision as totally possible. So we have one extra user here who is a monk. Short bow, steel bow. Anything on this person? No. So the thing is that he should be down here. Probably right here. Or maybe in this area. But we should be approaching these guys pretty close. He's actually a promoted unit, so that's something we've got to keep in mind when we actually go ahead and fight this guy. So, yeah. You know what? Rebecca, stay back here. Kill this guy. Good stuff. Good stuff. Hey, she's level 13. I think. Yep, level 13. Okay, good. Good. So, considering that... Who needs to be healed? Place you here. If no one needs to be healed in this particular spot, so I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna trade you, and then I'm gonna use the staff, the torch, right here. And this should be able to reveal more of the map. It's 15 experience, that's pretty sweet. Alright, good. Oh, baby, yeah, this actually is pretty awesome. So, if you can see, he is a Nomad Trooper. This is the promoted version of a Nomad in this game. Then the thing is that there's only one Nomad in this entire game that we can actually get to our party. And that is Wrath, Wrath is an okay unit. If you want to use a Nomad, anyone who, like, swords and... anyone who can use swords and a bow that's on horseback, then this is your guy. Anyway. So, the awesome thing that about killing this dude is that he actually gives us the Orion's Bolt. It's the promotion item for archers, so that's pretty damn sweet. And we gotta be careful when we're actually fighting him, so, because he's gonna be using a steel sword, and he hits for 23, so that's pretty damn scary. And his stats are actually okay. So if anything, we wanna make it so that we can actually, we are gonna be using, most likely, like a lance wielder. For right now, we block his ass in, and then just make it so that he attacks the lance users with his sword. Because there's not necessarily any other way to actually make him swap out. Because his bows are going to be very accurate, and he's going to hit really freaking hard, so that's really scary. Anyway, so we're going to place these units down here. Yeah, we're going to place these units slowly forward. We can't really do too much right now, fortunately. And Hector, go down here. Yeah, you guys, you're fine. If anything, I think it's okay for us to place Lucius down here. Keep you here, and keep Ellawood here. All right, let's see how this plays out. Alrighty. Okay, guys, level 14, which is good. I think. 14, yeah. 14. Damn, his speed is fucking high. Alright, let's do it. Come on, Canis. Bam. Yes, you got the second attack off. Alright, good. Now he has a Nosferatu tome, which is awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. And he got a level.
Ugh. Excuse me for the stretch. Okay. Got some res, got some magic. Awesome.
And he got a Nosferatu tome. Oh, that's hilarious. You're not gonna even be able to damage Lucius.
You cannot handle my strongest magic. You're much too weak.
Alrighty. So if anything, we gotta make it so that we take out Uhai soon. This is actually really nerve-wracking. Really, really nerve-wracking. Because he's gonna be hitting fucking hard. Like, really hard. And that's really scary. Alright. So if anything, we want to make it so that we stay out of these guys' range. So, just keep them around Raven and Bart, and then we should be totally fine. So I'm gonna go here. You are going to go next to your sister. You gonna go down here. How far is your range? Alright. Up to the tree is going to be fine. Wait here. Rebecca, you guys, you know you're fine. You guys can stay over here. Yeah, these guys are fine to stay here. This is okay. So we have all these units to figure out this little puzzle of actually how to kill Uhai. Who needs to be healed? Oh, well, Canis definitely needs to be healed. Okay. So from here, holy shit, he can actually attack very, very far. I'm hoping he doesn't move. Like, I'm legitimately hoping he just does not move. Scary. Okay. I'm gonna place Raven down here. Place him down here. I'm actually gonna pop a Vulnery. It might seem a little like overkill to place him right there, but I think this is fine. He's within the attack range of some of these nomads, so you should draw them out a little bit. And I'll place Bart here as well. I can't imagine he would be in a position where he would get completely wrecked, so this is okay. Guy, it's a little scary, so use a Vulnery, and after this we should be able to end our turn. Okay, see what we got going on. Alright, good. One of the nomads was baited in to attacking us. I'm hoping that they don't just stack all their damage on one person. Oh fuck, they're actually stacking their damage on one person. And he dodged. Great. Now it depends on if Uhai moves. Does he move? So we are technically within his range. You motherfucker. Alright, so we are within his range, but he's not actually attacking us, which is awesome. So that gives me a little breathing room to move my units around and make it so that we're not going to get completely killed. Alright, you are going to kill this guy. Good. And we are also going to move Bart. Bart should be able to get the kill on the other guy. Good level gains, good level gains. Okay, we're going to place you here. Take this guy out, please. Do not miss. Damn it! Asshole. Okay, who can we use to clean up your mess? Yeah, we'll move you here. And, oh fuck, alright. If anything, we should prepare for you to get hit. I hope you don't! Okay, cool. Good. Good. Alright. Fantastic. Okay, so I'm gonna actually place the Pegasus Knights along this edge. They should attract this homie to attacking them. This homie meaning this guy. And we're gonna make it so that our units will be able to move in closer when the time is right. So we're gonna place you here, and Hector, move your ass over here. Alright, Canis, you are going to move down as well, and then Priscilla, you're going to move down as well. Unfortunately, you're not going to be able to heal anybody, it looks like, so you're just going to use your torch. Use your torch, if only for the extra XP. So I'm going to place you here, and torch it up. Alright, 15 XP, son. It's lit. Alright, now just end the turn. Alright, good. He was baited into attacking. Florina, what the fuck? You're supposed to be getting, like, the double attacks off. Okay. So, let's take some stock of what's going on. Fiora, go in here, attack with your javelin. Hopefully you hit. Damn straight, son. Now, we're gonna use your sister to get the kill. Unfortunately, there's no real use to actually having both Pegasus Knights, although they can both turn into pretty good units. It's not super important for us to use both Pegasus Knights, if only for the fact that you can't do the Pegasus Triangle attack. Because Farina is only available in the other chapter. So, right, we hear the music, we have 6 turns to kill him. Oh, goodness. Alright. Move our units down as much as possible. So his blood circle is 2 tiles away from him. So if his archer, so he's like right here. So if his longbow allows him to attack from 2 to 3, so it's like 1. So, okay, you can attack from here. That's diagonal. If anything, he can attack like an L. Yeah, like an L. Ugh, this is a little scary. So we're gonna place Hector down here. He's the most tanky of all, probably the most tanky of all of our characters. Place you here. I'm a little scared about placing a unit there. anything, I will place Raven here. Raven, Bart, and these guys should be able to take him on. It depends on what he equips. If he equips a sword, then we will go in with our ranged units and try to do as much damage. But if he ends up going with his bow, slightly scary, but we will make it so that we can actually place our other units forward. We're gonna place him here. Hopefully this actually baits out an attack. Okay, this is a little nerve-wracking. I always get scared going against the bosses. So he should hopefully be baited to attack somebody, and he is. I am Uhai. I am the Soaring Hawk. Come. Hey. Oh, he got a second attack off. Hey! Get dodged, son. Alright, sick. So now, if anything, we want to make it so that we can go in here and start doing some sexy damage. And the problem is that he is very, very fast, and he can dodge quite a bit. Alright, so if anything, let's actually see how much damage we can do with these guys. So Uhai, unfortunately, is standing on top of a forest tile, so it's making it a little harder for us to actually hit him. Oh, fuck. Yeah, he's like super tanky. How much is your longsword gonna do? We'll do a decent amount of damage. If anything, we will have Hector attack with his wolf beetle. Are you the one responsible for Layla's death? And if I were, what would you do? I'm not entirely sure, but I do know that you would not draw another breath. Attack, land it! Oh, good job. Good job, son. Alright. Okay, so we need to actually land some damage. Fuck. It could work. It's just that it's not very likely. Okay. He'll do 5 damage. At least it's only guaranteed to hit 1. How much would your thunder do? Only 3. Fuck. We can use our other units to rescue people. Yeah. How much would you do? Like, literally 0. How much would you do? Literally 0. Okay. It's quite the predicament. So what I want to actually have happen is I want to make it so that one of our units, whoever has the most skill, and I guess it's Urk, go in here and do some damage. All right, you have a 53% chance. You have a 64% chance. Alright, if anything, we're going to have Lucius go ahead and attack him, and then if anything, we're going to have Raven go ahead and pick up the kill. I anticipated Lucius taking some damage. At least he actually hits. So, Raven, I need you to be a bro, okay? I need you to be a fucking bro and kill this guy. Kill this guy on this turn. You're gonna be using your longsword, right? Okay, what's better? Fuck, this is the problem with probability that I'm really, really terrible at. What's better? A 2 times 56% chance or a 166% chance? I wanna think that the 56% chance is probably better. And some people are probably saying, like, yes, you idiots. The answer should be totally obvious, but this is like the Jeopardy situation all over again. Well, not Jeopardy. Who Wants to Be a Millionaire situation? Like, oh, fuck, I'm freezing because I am put on the spot. Anyway, yeah, I think I'm gonna go for the 2 times 56. So let's do it. Fuck, I hope we don't fuck it up. Oh, hell yeah, yes. Gooh, well done. You are stronger, stronger than I expected. Out of respect, a final gift from me. From here, go south, turn at the rotted tree, head west. There lies a path to the Dragon's Gate. Yeah. Oh, level, son. You know what? That's good. That's very good. And we got the Orion's Bolt! Woo! Send this back to Merlinus. Uhai,
I wish we could have met under different circumstances. Do we trust him? He was a Sakaian. He would not lie. I at least choose to believe him. Let's go then. To the Dragon's Gate. Accept the side quest? Hell yeah, we're accepting the side quest. That's what we did all this hubbub for. Anyway, yeah, well that actually went pretty damn sweet. So, thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching. And I'll see you guys in Chapter 18X, which is Imprisoner of Magic.